નમસ્કાર, હું આદર્શ છું. વેલકમ ટુ આદર્શ એજ્યુકેશન સોસાયટી.
સ્ટાન્ડર્ડ 7th, સબ્જેક્ટ સોશિયલ સાયન્સ, ચેપ્ટર નંબર 1, રાજપૂત એજ, ન્યૂ રૂલર્સ એન્ડ સ્ટેટ્સ.
Now we learn about the administration of Rajput era. So during Rajput era, various Rajput dynasty ruled. At that time, there were changes in the ruling and dynasty, but there were no changes in the situation in the political dynasty. So during the Rajput era, because that one Rajput era is around 500 years. So during the Rajput era, many dynasties came to the throne, they become the king, and their heredity is also different. So all the kings, many dynasties ruled over in Rajput era. But at that time, there were changes in ruling system. So ruling dynasties are changes, but they are saying that there were no change in the situation in the political dynasty. So all kings are different, their dynasties are different, all the things were different, we can say. But there were no changes in the situation of political dynasties. In the Rajput era, position of king was hereditary. It was not necessary that the eldest son of the king would become the ruler. So here the meaning of hereditary means passed on the from parent to child. Which things we get from the parents, that one is known as a hereditary. So in the Rajput era, Rajput time, so position of king, so that one is hereditary, means their whose king and their children will become the king, that one is known as a hereditary. But it was not necessary that only the eldest son of the king would become the ruler. So that one is not compulsory that who is the eldest son will become the king. King used to make any one of his sons at the Yuvraj or his successor who later on become the king. If king have 3 or 4 sons, so he can choose that who will become the king, who is able to handle all the kingdom. So king have authority to choose his son as a Yuvraj or successor, means after the king die or he decided I will not be, now I don't want to become king. As a Yuvraj, he can also handle the kingdom, so they can also become successor, and also later then he become the king. Their instance means example. So there are instances, means many examples are there, which show that people or courtiers used to elect or select king of their choice. So there are many examples are there. So many king also and also courtier, means Rajdarbari, also can there elect their king and king of their choice. They can choose their king and also they can elect the king. There are also like king Yashastra of Kashmir was chosen by a committee of Brahmins. So there is also one example. Even here Yashastra also one of them, one example that king by king or by courtier they can elect their king. So Yashastra of from where Yashastra from Kashmir was, he was also chosen by committee of Brahmins. Ministers were of two types at that time. So that time there were two types of minister. First one is known as Amatya, means minister, and second one is secretaries. Amatya's job was to negotiate and do political. So what is the job, what is the duty of Amatya, means minister? So his duty, that job was negotiate, means samadhan, compromise, negotiate and political, that one Amatya's duty. And what is secretary's duty? And the secretary's job was to fight and make peace. So that one secretary's duty to fight and battle him and make peacefully in the kingdom. The final decision on every policy was taken by the king. At the last moment, each and every decision taken, all the decisions are taken by the king. At that time, the bureaucrat of the regime were holding positions like Mahapratihar and Dandanayak. The head of the town council was called mayor. So here, the meaning of bureaucrat, that one is government department, and regime means system of the government. So at that time, government departments or system of the government which are holding the position like Mahapratihar and Dandanayak. So there are also two types of people, Dandanayak and Pratihar. The head of the town council, so head of the town is known as a mayor or Nagarpati. Village institution occupied. Occupied means to take a place. So village institution occupied a very important place during the Rajput rule. So here we can understand that who are the council of town, that one is known as a Nagarpati or as a mayor. But what's about the village? So in the village institution, all this work also occupied means to take a place very important at the Rajput era, Rajput time. These institutions have developed so well as that one is known as a Gram Panchayat. In Gram Panchayat remained important even at the time of Mughals. So at the Mughal time also there were Gram Panchayat, and who are working in the town, they were also known as a Nagarpati or mayor. So at Mughal time, this Gram Panchayat also working. Just like North Gram Panchayat occupied an important place in the south also. So in the north place and south place, same situation are there. Towns who are holding all the things, they are known as a mayor, and in the villages, there are Gram Panchayat who are holding all the things. It is head was called as a Mukhi or Sarpanch. So here we are talking about the villagers. In the village, who is the head? That one is known as a Mukhi or as a Sarpanch. Although Gram Panchayat used to give judgment in many matters, yet the king was the supreme authority in the legal system of the state. But last moment, who take the decision? King have a authority to take all this decision. Now next one is trade commerce, means related to business. There was a separate department for taking care of commerce related matters in the Rajput era. Era means period of time. Here we are using era, means using the period of time, Rajput time. There was a separate department for trade. There is a separate department in the also Nagarpalika. There also separate department for water, all this. So same thing at Rajput era. That time also trade commerce, that one is also separate. Means different department. They are taking care of commercial related matters. So which things are going outside, coming inside, export, import, all the things are in a different department, and they are handling all the things. This department used to make arrangement for collection of tax over the foreign trade, decide the value of things, and purchase essential commodities. Commodities means material can be bought and sold. Means like grains, oil, all the things required in the state. So what is their duty? So their duty to handle all the arrangement, all the things for collection of tax. So if we are doing export business, so they have to take some tax from the foreigners. If we are import, so there all the things also we have to pay tax here. So all the tax over the foreign trade, and beside the value, what will be the price for the things. So all the things are included in the department of trade commerce. Import, that one is a separate. So all the commodities, means commodities matlab material, can bought and sold. Which things we are exporting and importing, these things like grain, gold, oil, all the things we are selling. So all the things we have to pay tax, otherwise from the foreigner have to pay tax for all the things. Main sources of tax collection was land revenue, which was 1/6 part of the production. So what is the production? If we are selling from here to sending in a other foreign country, if we have income of 1,20,000, so 1,20,000 divided by 1/6 part. So if we are taking tax that there are 1,20,000, so 1/6 part of this lavish tax, that one is around 20,000 rupees. So 20,000 rupees they have to pay tax. So that's why here is explaining that each one-sixth part of the production. If the production is 1,20,000 and we are selling at 1,50,000, but what is the main production is that one 1,20,000 and 1/6 part they have to pay as a tax. Revenue was also collected from the ports, check ports and irrigation. Stambhatir means khambar, now we known as a khambar, and Bhargavuj, now we also known as a Bharuj. Ports of Gujarat were famous for foreign trade at that time. So all these work are also doing as a water business. So sometimes also we learn that land business, land type, transportation. So this is a water transportation, and that one is also trade commerce. At that time in Gujarat, there are two main, Khambhat and Bharuj are the main two port at Rajput era. So they are doing their business, their trade, which tax they have to give, which tax they have to take from the foreigners. All the things are decided and made. Then after, king was the final who take all the decision. And who make the production, they have to pay 1/6 part as a tax. Now last one is foreign attacks on India. Muslim invaders. So invaders means attacker. Who attack on us, that one is the invaders known as an attacker. Means they attack on India. So Muslim invaders means Muslim attacker. Invade India between the 8th and the 12th century. In the 8th century, Muhammad Ibn Qasim attack on northwest part of India in order to extend boundaries of the Arab kingdom. So as well as we know that all the kings who are the going for the battlefield, so it means they want to increase their border, so they want to increase their kingdom. So same thing in the 8th century, Muhammad Qasim also attacked on northwestern part of India. To what is their intention? Their intention is to increase their border, to make their kingdom very big and to make very prosperous. So at that time, from the Arab kingdom, he want to make his boundary big. The army of Sabuk Tekin also invaded from northwest part, but these invasions did not help the invaders to establish their power in India. But at that, Rajput rulers are so brave and they are not allowed the invaders who are attacked on India, so they are not successful at that time. After that, seeing abundant means large quantity. Abundant means large quantity. So after that, seeing abundant wealth, Sultan Muhammad Ghazni. So at that time, Sultan Muhammad Ghazni also invaded India several times between 1000 AD to 1026 AD. So at that time, India was very prosperous and most of Gujarat was fully prosperous. So that time, Muhammad Ghazni also attacked on Gujarat many times from 1000 AD to 1026 AD. Seeing abundant wealth there, the main reason of Muhammad Ghazni invasion was, what was the invasion? That India's abundant wealth. So that time India had too much wealth, too much property, so too much money. So the attack on India, so main thing is to attack on India and also to get all the money. He kept invading India again and again. And each time he invaded with more power. So one time he attacked on India, and also he get well. So again he made his army very strong, and again he attack on India, most of in Gujarat. The Indians could not unite to form a powerful army. As a result, in 1026 he invaded Somnath and looted a lot of wealth. So many times they are attacking, but they are attacking maybe around 16 times. Muhammad Ghazni attacked on Gujarat at Somnath temple, but each and every time he made his army very strong, but there were something are missing. So there are no unity at that time. So the power, we don't have a powerful army to attack and to give answer on attacker. So at that time, what was the result? The result was that in 1026, he invaded Somnath and loot the Somnath. India was invaded again from the same direction from the where Muhammad Ghazni attacked about 150 years after the former of invasion. After the death of Muhammad Ghazni, there were battle among them for power in Ghazni, but our rulers could not take advantages of this weakness as the power was not stable. So many times Muhammad Ghazni attacked on India, and also he made each and every time he made too much powerful army. So they looted the India and also get too much money, too much wealth from India. But after the death of Muhammad Ghazni, all the kingdom become alone, but they are intercepted, they are fighting each other. But Indian army did not take the, they did not take the advantages of this person. So that's why, what were the rulers of that time? They did not take the advantages which are fighting each other for after the death of Muhammad Ghazni. So advantages of this weakness is the power was not stable. Consuming country means, as a result, what happened? Shahabuddin Ghori invaded India in the 12th century intentionally. He had to suffer some defeats, but finally he defeated Prithviraj Chauhan in the second battle at Tarai battlefield and established his power in Delhi. All the situation as the result, what happened? Shahabuddin Ghori also attacked on India, and also many times he was defeated, but at last he was also defeated to Prithviraj Chauhan, and he was also become the ruler of Delhi. So here we can understand that many times India was attacked by the foreign invasion, and also Muhammad Ghazni many times attacked on Gujarat, especially Somnath, and then after last Shahabuddin Ghori also attacked, and that time Prithviraj Chauhan also defeated by him. So here we can say, so the Terai battlefield established in the power in Delhi.
Thank you for joining us.